30 miles from Burton in Stoke, PC's Darren Belford and Kerry Broadhurst are hearing news over the radio of another violent attack.
PC Kerry Broadhurst, response officer at Hanley.
The assault has taken place in the middle of the afternoon, in a pub in the city centre. There's no time to lose, and in minutes, they reach the scene. Kerry finds the victim, still out cold on the floor.
What's actually happened then?
Smacked, basically.
Who by?
Across the head.
Who by, what with?
The person's gone, I don't know, with his fist.
OK.
The man's injuries look bad and an ambulance is on its way.
I don't really want to disturb him until the ambulance get here.
Darren needs to find out what has gone on.
What's happened, Doc?
And who is responsible.
The lad just hit him.
Where's the lad that's hit him?
Well, he went.
But some of the locals don't like their afternoon drinking interrupted by the police.
Down, folks. If you've got something to say, evidential, come and see me shortly, all right? Other than that, leave it. You might as well just keep your mouth to yourself, haven't you?
Thank you, my friend.
How do I get hold of the CCTV, Doc?
Kerry has established that the woman caring for the man who got hit saw exactly what happened.
Right, no. Can you tell me what the offenders looked like, what the person that hit him looked like?
But she's reluctant to talk.
The person that's hit him?
Okay.
Not really, no, because if we've got some offenders, we need to lock them up. Was there one, two, three?
One.
Is it somebody that's in here?
There's not any in there.
Okay, who is it? Because you know who it is, don't you?
He's gone, yeah.
Who was it?
You know when you were born?
I don't know him.
Describe him to me then. Because you obviously know what's gone on.
Knows me in here.
Okay.
And I'm going to get the
okay,
this.
Can do if this lady's happy to hold this chap's head.
The witness is worried about being overheard, so Kerry takes her outside.
OK. Right. Description of the offender. White, black, male, female?
I'm going to get in the...
Do you want to tell me?
Just come around the corner and hear.
It's vital Kerry gets the offender's description before he gets too far away.
Getting the for this, and I've got enough going on in my life.
They don't want to give us information because they don't want to get involved. It's difficult for people to give the police information and come forward and say, yes, I actually saw this, because if they were there and they were the only person there, they're quite easily identifiable. So it does put some people in a difficult position. Are you going to tell me or not? Because I've got more important things, if not.
I will tell you.
Right, go on then.
Young lad on crutches.
Yeah.
And if I saw him, I'll be able to...
Was he white, black?
White.
How old, roughly?
Under 30.
30. And what was he wearing?
I don't know if he got a burgundy top on.
And he's on crutches.
Okay. With the assailant on crutches, he shouldn't have gone too far.
1-4, suspect, it's a white male, early 30s, 5'8", medium build, with dark, short hair. He's wearing a black Velcro boot for an ankle injury on his left foot, and he is on crutches.
Back inside, the paramedics have arrived, and it's clear the man's groggy from too much drink, as well as from being hit. Fortunately, the whole pub has its own CCTV network for exactly times like this. And what the cameras have picked up is shocking.
From looking at the CCTV and from what people have said, the gentleman in the pub's been punched by somebody, an unknown male, and then there's a big pool of blood on the floor. He's got quite a nasty gash to the back of his head, I would say probably about 2 inches, and a considerable lump. The offender's quite distinctive in terms of he's got like a Velcro boot on one of his feet and he's got crutches, so shouldn't be too difficult to track down if he's still in the area. We've passed the details to CCTV so they can do an area search, and we'll see where we go from there with it, really.
Being on crutches, you can't run, but you can hide. But not for long from a CCTV camera.
Apparently there's a chance that the offender may be in this next pub, so we're just going to go in here and have a look for him now.
Darren's not taking any chances. He's clocked the man, and he's bringing him in.
You have to come with us, pal.
Why?
Don't look at me like that. I've just watched you on CCTV. Let's get it sorted. So we're not getting
nothing. All of a sudden, the witness from earlier breezes in and confirms the cops have got the right man.
You could stand up. How can I stand up, you daft git?
Right, well, you're under arrest for assault, OK? You didn't have to say anything. It may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned, something which you'll later rely on in court.
I can't walk with no crutches.
Anything you do say may be given in evidence, all right?
Well, we need to get my signal.
We'll get your... OK.
Get all these as well.
Yeah.
The suspect's girlfriend is claiming the other man started it all by being verbally abusive.
What he was saying may have been disgusting. I am not saying it wasn't. It's no right to spark him, though.
Really? I stood up for my self-defence because I'm on one leg.
Sparked
don't shout.
One leg.
Put your hand down.
No.
Come on.
One leg.
Come on.
We'll make a statement when you're all there.
No, you're not having a cigarette. You're not having a cigarette.
One leg.
You're not having a cigarette.
Don't grab me when I can't walk.
You're saying you want a cigarette. You're not having a cigarette. You're under arrest.
I want.
No, you won't, pal.
Please.
Don't disrespect me when I can't
I'm
walk.
I'm talking to you. You've done nothing wrong.
Come on, Doc.
I haven't done nothing wrong.
You're defending me.
Thank you.
Come get my statement
on here.
Well, that's
scumbags, though. Here you are.
Do you want to stop it to register? Else
you're
should
also
be under arrest.
Pop the cord in.
Yeah. Yes, carry on.
You don't have to say anything, but you may harm a defence, but you do not mention when questioned, something which you later rely on in court.
Right.
So I suggest you calm it down, not be interviewed whilst you're in this angry state, all right? You're on CCTV, you can get as and argue as much as you want. It's on footage. Can you come round this side for me, please, mate? What's your name? Well, shuffle over then. Do you want that seat pushing forward? Do you want the seat pushing forward?
No.
OK.
The man now decides it's his turn to be the victim.
You're saying I'm going to get up and fight with somebody? I'm saying self-defence. If somebody comes across to me, young man, and has a go, I'm not going to stand... Well, I can't stand there for one. I pushed him away. Out the way. Self-defence, I pushed him away to get out the pub.
If I see that on the CCTV, I've got to do something. I can't just turn a blind
eye. Yeah,
eye,
you pick on me. He's got on crutches. He was disabled. I didn't hit him.
All right.
I pushed him away with my hand. If that's hitting somebody by pushing somebody away, give me some strength.
The CCTV shows that he punches the male straight in the face. And then he's fallen to the floor. He's got quite a nasty cut to the back of his head. And it kind of speaks volumes, really, how serious something as small as one punch can be.
At the custody suite, there's an unexpected twist in the tale.
She attacked me.
From a familiar face.
She attacked me.
Kerry's witness, who's got herself arrested, after, she claims, being attacked for grassing to the cops.
It sounds like, reading between the lines, the defendant for the assault partner has shouted at this female and there's been some kind of altercation between the two of them. And now she's been arrested.
From what I can gather in there, no names have been said, but the incident they're describing sounds like the incident you've been at. And it sounds like that your missus has accused her of grassing and they've had a set to and she's at your missus. Or if your missus has gone wading in to protect your honour, it's just made things 10 times worse.
It's that strange hour, I think. Everybody's quite inebriated in that pub. There's clearly a link between what's happened with her and what's happened with him. It's just happened at two separate times, quite close together.
All of the charges against both the man and the woman were dropped after no one in the pub that afternoon wished to pursue any complaints.